So today is a big day because we're going to talk about the est of calculus. What do we mean by the est? Well, we're going to do things like finding the best, the biggest, the smallest, the fastest, the shortest, the slowest, the tallest, anything that you can say, I want the best case scenario of. In other words, this is one of the big reasons why people care about calculus. So today we're talking optimization. All right, well, let's get into it. Now, our idea is we want to find some value that produces the best option. You see, optimization says that we're trying to produce the desired result and we have competing interests. We might say, well, as we put more of this element into play, it worsens the effect over here and vice versa. So it's about finding that balance, that trade-off where we have the best net outcome. So how do we do optimization? How do we find these ideal situations? Well, in essence, when we're looking for optimization, we're trying to find a maximum or a minimum. And we've talked about how to find maximums and minimums. They happen at critical points. So we say, good. So we're going to be looking for critical points, and then we're going to be able to classify them. So what do we need to do? Well, we need to be able to get to the point to find critical points, which means we got to come up with functions. And this is where optimization problems are probably a little bit more challenging. You see, what we're going to do is we're going to start out by using words, saying, here's a scenario. So what we have to do is translate, you know, here's this beautiful language. Turn it into a beautiful math formula. And it's this first step. That's the hard part about optimization. Now, a word of warning when you're doing optimization problems, you have to make sure that you actually have the right answer. Sometimes we'll might say, well, we only have one answer, so that must be it. But as an example, you might be looking to find something which is the best, in other words, a maximum, and you end up finding the worst, a minimum. You see, critical points, you don't know whether it's the max or the min. So you should test, or you should use context and say, okay, is this the right answer? Oftentimes, it's useful to take a few seconds and say, did I do this right? Well, of course, we should always take a few seconds to make sure whether or not we did something right. All right, so not really much to say because it's not so much new techniques. It's saying, let's use the techniques to solve problems. So what's our procedure? Well, the big thing, understand the problem. You can't solve a problem until you understand it. So you got to make sure you understand what's going on. For example, what is it you're trying to optimize? That's what you need to turn into a function. What is it you're allowed to vary? And anything that's allowed to vary should be given a variable name. Hence, you know, that's why we call it a variable. Look for relationships. This is particularly important if you say, oh, there's multiple things happening. Well, we're only able to handle functions of one variable. So we have to be careful. So we can use those relationships to help us get down to a single variable. Now, draw a picture. See, a lot of problems that involve optimizations, there's a visual aspect of it. And once you see the picture, you can say, oh, I see where the trade-off is happening, and I see how to connect what it is I'm trying to optimize with what it is I'm allowed to vary, which helps us to find a formula. So as often as you can, try to draw a picture. Not all problems are able to draw a picture, but those that can, you should do it. And step three, now this won't always apply to every problem, but when we're trying to optimize, we need to get down to one variable. We can only handle one thing varying right now. Eventually, as we work our way up, we'll get up to multivariable calculus. And then we have multiple things varying. So what does that mean? Well, what we have is if there's two or more things changing, we say, hey, there must be some other relationship in play that connects them together. That's why we said, hey, look for those other relationships. With those relationships, we can solve for one variable in terms of the other, and then we can do a substitution to reduce the number of variables involved. So that's how we get down to functions of one variable. All right. Now, we're ready to do what we've been learning. How do you find and classify critical points? Well, set the, take the derivative, set it equal to zero, maybe worry about whether or not it's undefined, and don't forget to check the boundary. Some prompts have a natural boundary built into it, and we say, okay, well, it's possible that it might be that the best case scenario is right at the boundary, so you should check. And then our last step, all right, what is it? Give the answer. Okay, good. Now, of course, when we're asked for the answer, it might be asking us different things, like what is the optimal outcome, or the if you like, the value of the function at the optimum. Of course, you might say, what value gives us the optimal outcome? So in other words, what's the input? And so there's all sorts of different scenarios. So make sure when you're doing a problem and you get to the end, you want to make sure you get all the points, right? That's our goal. It's like Pokemon, got to get them all right? So just make sure you follow the directions. So that's the idea. It's pretty simple. Of course, the trick is how to do it in practice. So we're going to do probably a fair amount of practice with this. And the big thing, again, focus on how do I take words, sentences, transform them into formulas that we can work with. So that's an important thing. In essence, this is where we start to say, oh, the world around us, there's actually something to say in the mathematics of it, because there's a lot of interesting things happening. And so if we can learn to think about the world and say, okay, here's the things which are varying, here's some relationships, here's some formulas, we're starting to turn into the place where we have all these mathematical tools that we can use to help figure out what's going on. All right, well, I hope you enjoy the practice.